go? All
right. Good luck.
Have you ever felt left out when not a part of a group? Back when I lived in Hong Kong, I didn't have many friends in my new school. Sport really helped me with that. I played rugby every week for my local club. We were a family, a community. It brought us together. When I first came to Green School 3 years ago, I was introduced to the idea of Ultimate Frisbee. I was hooked, playing whenever I could. I especially liked when I played with the cool connection known as KKC in the after school activity, also known as ASA, I was involved in. One day I was thinking that I don't see very much of the local students on campus, and maybe there was a way to bridge this gap and bring our two communities closer together and build bonds with each other that would not have been there before. In 1871, William Frisbee opened the Frisbee Pie Company. Students from nearby universities would throw the pie tins and yell, Frisbee. In 1948, Los Angeles building inspector named Walter Frederick Morrison invented a plastic version of the disc that could fly further and with better accuracy. Those pie tins evolved into what we know today as Frisbee, the great sport where you can have fun and pass between friends, or the amazing game where one team hucks the disc to the other side and that team tries to move the disc around the field and score in the end zone. In the last 10 years, Ultimate Frisbee has become one of the world's fastest growing sports. In 2006, there were 3.9 million people playing Ultimate Frisbee competitively. Ultimate Frisbee is not only serious and competitive, but also a sport that offers a unique sense of sportsmanship and community. This sport was the perfect opportunity for me to bond with my peers and invite students and adolescents from a local community to come to our school and play. An issue that I've seen in our Green School community is that the KKC kids aren't participating in our after-school activities and sports events. I rarely see students from the KKC school on campus, and this is a problem. They are part of our community. They should all be welcome to come and play. I decided that organizing an ASA and a Frisbee tournament was the best way to unite our two worlds. When I first set out on my quest journey, I wanted to physically make a Frisbee, but quickly realized the most important thing to me is building community, so I shifted my focus to that. First, I got in contact with the Badawi and set up an ASA. The first couple of ASAs, not that many students showed up. But after a while, and after I talked to a group of KKC students, there were many local students interested in playing Frisbee. I had to get ready for my tournament. To do so, I wrote an advertisement in the Green School newsletter, presented in assemblies, and made posters. I planned everything for the tournament and started getting it done. I wanted to make sure this tournament was going to work out, so I contacted different international schools and local schools. Once I started to reach out, people started to sign up. The day of the tournament came. I woke up super early to get to school and prepare everything. Once everything was set up and everyone had arrived, we started to get into our teams and play. I hope you realize when watching this video, you're watching an entire diversity of a community coming together, learning new skills, and having a ton of fun. Coming together like this, no one feels left out. Everyone has a role to play, regardless of skills or language. This was my aim. This was the purpose of the tournament. When I'm playing Frisbee, on the field, everyone is equal, no matter how different.
Second, don't you tell me what you think that I could be. I'm the one.
son of a accurate. I know the strength don't come without strategy. I know the speed that don't come without cavities. I know the passages come with some traffic. I start from the basement, end up in the attic. And third, then third, whoever comes to y'all, they simply can't come. Let's get mathematic, I'm up in the school. Is you a believer? I get a unicorn out of a zebra. I wear my uniform like a tuxedo. This dragon, the oldest bread, don't need a breeder. Love you, we see the son of a leader.
Achieve a great victory together. I thought today was really fun. Frisbee is one of the few sports I can play, and I really found it fun to work together with the local school and BIS.
In my veins, oh, ooh, ooh. But they never did, ever did, ever did, ever did, ever did, ever did, ever did, till it broke up when it rained down. It rained down like.
I set up the AAC so the KKC and local students have a chance to learn Frisbee and develop their skills. The end goal for my project was to host a Frisbee tournament, but really, I just wanted the local students to feel a part of our community. Being a part of a community is really special, and I found it important that the KKC is recognized as a part of that. Connecting to the local students has tried to be achieved in the past, but there's never been a permanent connection. For example, a few years ago, a Jalan Jalan went to local schools and taught Frisbee, as well as learning Bahasa and teaching English with them. This was a great initiative, however, it was just a one-time thing. I learned from this experience and focused on making long-lasting connections, which are best made through sport. I felt that the best way to do this was to have a tournament where players from all different backgrounds, languages, and ethnicity come together in one day and just have fun, building those connections that are not there. Community events build stronger connections within communities. Look at Bali. All the time you see people coming together for ceremonies, each of them playing their own part. That's why they are so close and the community of Banjars is so strong. I am so humbled that the tournament was such a success. So many people came and everyone had fun. In the future, I plan to have another tournament so that the connections we have made can continue and those relationships can grow. The plan for this program is an ongoing ASA, and the hope is that we can continue integration through our Green School PW program. I hope everyone will join again next time, along with many others. I would especially like to say thank you to my mentor, Pat Baxter, for helping me so much with my project. I would also like to say thank you to my mom, Ibu Dawi, and all the Quest teachers that have helped me on my journey. I couldn't have done it without you.